First Nation people and the British Crown. Both parties enter agreement that provide...
Kane McNabb is excited to perform on stage. He memorized his lines, all 11 pages. McNabb is the narrator in his school's play Treaty for All at George Gordon Education Center.
Yeah, I'm learning a lot about treaties and how they're made.
Grade 4 teacher Amanda Moosemay created and directed the play, aimed at teaching her students about their Indigenous history.
I wrote it for my social studies unit. I wanted to teach them something that was visual for them, and it worked out fantastic. They did their unit very well.
Around 20 students took part in the historical show, wearing costumes and using sets designed by staff. Brian McNabb, the school's principal, says it's the first time the school has hosted a dinner theater.
Our kids are naturally gifted. You know, our teachers are finding out what gifts they have and utilizing them, and one of them is using the arts.
Treaty 4, also known as the Qu'Appelle Treaty, was signed in 1874 to solidify a deal between the Crown and First Nation people. The agreement allowed the federal government to use Indigenous land in exchange for payments and reserves. The treaty covers most of southeast Saskatchewan.
They're having a ceremony, and then they're signing the actual treaty. So it's really significant and really symbolic.
The play is also a fundraiser for students, raising money to support their school trip to Drumheller in June. Principal McNabb says this is just the beginning. The provincially run school is exploring future dance classes and performances, both traditional and contemporary, to teach students cultural movement.
I feel very proud when I see our students not only learning about their identity and their history, and then acting it out and portraying it before our community members.
As for McNabb, he can't wait to be in another play.
Everything is really fun, and we are a team.
From here, Principal McNabb hopes the school will hold more artistic events for students in the future to keep the history of Treaty 4 alive. Kathryn Fraser, CTV News, George Gordon, First Nation.